Mary was born without original sin, and she also lived without sin. 8th of December, Wednesday, reflection. Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. My dear friends, you should not misunderstand this feast by the Immaculate Conception of Jesus. Jesus was born, conceived without original sin. And this is not the conception of the Lord. This is the conception of Mary as a child in St. Anne's womb. So this is exactly the meaning of this feast. And also another thing you have to understand, she's not a God. She's not God. But then she was made pure because of Jesus. Teresa Ravilla beautifully says how she was conceived without original sin with the same power of Jesus, the Paschal mystery. The Paschal mystery is above time and space. So because of the Paschal mystery, the whole world, even now, today, tomorrow, everyone was saved. And also that Paschal mystery will go to the beginning of the world. All those who were in the darkness, they were saved. So in limbo, they were saved. Those who could not enter heaven, they were in limbo. So because of the Paschal mystery, everyone was saved. My dear friends, that same power has saved Mary from original sin. Teresa Avila says, she bring forth this example of a pit. So if a person is going and falling into that pit, so you can save that person after falling to the pit, but then you can save a person before falling to the pit. That's how Mary was saved. That's how Mary was conceived without original sin. Because why? Jesus, Son of Man, the most holy of holy. So for him to come, there should be a place of holy. And also, that's exactly why how the tabernacle was made pure. Those who touch the tabernacle, that denotes the presence of God. They fell dead. So imagine, the presence was on the Mount Sinai. Those who touched the mount, they were killed. No one could see the Lord face to face because they were pure, they were not pure. Imagine, if the Lord is going to come to this particular body, how that body should be made pure. It's important. It's important that we understand that she had to be immaculately conceived. And also she is the new Eve. In the book of Revelation chapter 3 verse 15, the Lord is saying, there will be enmity between you and the evil one, the serpent. So this woman is new Eve now. In the book of John, when Jesus called woman in wedding at Cana and beneath the cross, he called her woman. So this is the same word used in Genesis. So she becomes a new Eve. And Eve was born without original sin. And then here, she had to be born without original sin as a new Eve, my dear friends. And also, we find we find the revelation of, there are personal revelations where in 1830, Catherine Labore, she had the vision. And we have today, the Miraculous Medal. In the Miraculous Medal, Immaculate Conception is mentioned. And also in 1858, Bernadette, when Mother Mary appeared to her, they asked, what was her name? And she said, Immaculate Conception. So that's exactly how this feast was important in the Catholic Church. My dear friends, now she is conceived without original sin because of a reason. Because one thing, she is the new Eve, a new Adam, and she has to give birth to the God himself, so that she has to be pure. So what is important is, of course, she's born without original sin. It does not mean she is free from sin. No. God appeared to her and asked, and she said yes, because God wanted her consent, without which God will never do anything in her life. So her yes was important. She said yes. That yes was never backed by that Immaculate Conception. No. She was an ordinary person, and she had to say yes. And that yes was important. And she lived that yes until the end, my dear friends. So it's important that we think about our lives. Whenever in our baptism, we are born with original sin, of course. But then in our baptism, we are made pure because of Jesus' blood, because of Jesus' new life given to us. So we are pure. So then we are immaculate. We are without original sin the moment we are baptized. And also whenever we receive Eucharist, my dear friends, whenever we receive Eucharist, we become like Mary, isn't it? So that's why the second reading beautifully says, blessed be God with every spiritual, then he says, blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, even as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. So this is our calling too. This is our call. Mary has become our model because she lived a pure life. That's exactly, my dear friends, in the gospel, the Lord is saying, Mary, Angel Gabriel is saying, Mary, full of grace. And this term is only used to Mary, for no one else. And she was made pure because of grace. Grace is given by God. So we are given grace, my dear friends, to hold on to him, to be pure. Always. When you can be pure, when you give God the first and the best place. That's what exactly Mother Mary did in her life. So it's an invitation for us to say yes to him always. That we have to live a life of purity. So she has set the example. And also she's our mother who is in heaven. That always pray for you. She's always praying for you. And she's the one who is against devil, against all the evil forces in your life. So devil has a problem with her, my dear friends. So just be friendly. Make her your mother always. Because Jesus has given her at the beginning of the cross. Behold your mother. Behold your mother. Because Jesus knows we live in this impure world. We want to live a pure life. You have to have her. There's no other way. So Immaculate Conception. Mary, Immaculate Conception. Let's ask her to pray for us. Amen. May God bless you.